welcome to Brain Stuff. I'm Jonathan Strickland, and I had a question that came in, and seems that you guys want to know how lightsabers work. So, newsflash, they aren't real. I mean, I could talk about focus crystals and battery packs, but reality is these are just special effects. Now, those special effects are pretty cool. It's pretty straightforward, but it's also a very tedious process. Now, this is for the original trilogy. You know, the good ones. You see, what the actors would do in shooting the movies would be to hold aluminum rods that were painted a specific color. And they would actually fight with these aluminum rods as if they were lightsabers. But after the film was shot, it was then taken to an effects artist. At that point, what the effects artist would do would trace around each of these rods. Finally, the artist would paint the correct color in that outline so that they would replace the aluminum rod with the lighted lightsaber effect. You know, something like this right here. Now, this is an old rapier scabbard we're using, and we've put some reference points here for our artist to use when replacing this in post-production. These days, we don't necessarily paint over frames of film individually. We can actually do all that digitally. Now we have software suites that allow you to do this automatically. You just give it a couple of reference points, and it does the rest. Pretty cool. Huh. Sith. Anyway, there are even some hackers who have managed to use the Microsoft Xbox Kinect sensor to create this effect in real time. So you just hold a broomstick or a rod in your hands and it'll turn it into a lightsaber on your television screen. Vroom, bzz, vroom. Normally I'd have someone to do the sound effects for me, but our budget was cut. Right, so if you enjoyed this video, make sure you like it and subscribe to the video channel. We've got a lot more interesting questions to answer in the near future.